Hey, what's up guys? Jeremy here from RoboDK. Today we will learn to import a cutting path from Mastercam to RoboDK. The fastest way to do this is to use our free plugin for Mastercam. You simply create your cutting path in the cam software and a few minutes later, you have a robot program ready to go. Okay, enough for the intro, let's get working. In this example, we want to trim the excess material around that car hood. To do so, the robot uses a cutting tool mounted on a spindle. This job is totally suited for a robot. It covers a big work area and it requires a multi-axis machine. The white lines that you see here represent the direction of the tool along the green path. Let's look at our station. We have a Fennec robot, the spindle, and a jig to hold the car hood. We have the machining reference, which is where we will import our part, and we have the cutting program. And last but not least, we have our robot machining project and its settings. This is where most of the work will take place in a few minutes. Now that we have seen the end result, let's jump to the empty station. It's the exact same thing, but without the part and the path. Okay, now we can go in Mastercam and launch the cutting simulation. We can see that the software adjusts the orientation of the tool to match the cutting surface we need to follow. Now we want to transfer that path in RoboDK. If we look at the top of the window, we can see the RoboDK tab. This is the plugin. If you want to install it, I will leave a link in the description to set it up properly. First thing to do is to import the part in the station. Click on the RoboDK robot setup and choose load part. You can close that window and go to RoboDK. The car hood is now at its place on the jig. Now the question is, how does RoboDK know that I want the part at this exact position? It's simple. When I set up my station, I placed the machining reference at a specific position. I can reveal the frame, and you see that it's there. When I drew the part in the CAD software, I created the origin at this exact position. Now, when I import the part, RoboDK will match the origin of the part with the origin of the machining reference. Now that we know that, I can hide the frame. Next step is to set up the cutting path. Let's go back in Mastercam. Again, I have my cutting path all around the hood. I can go in the RoboDK tab and click on RoboDK Update Selected Operations. Now back to RoboDK. The path was imported around the car hood. In the robot machining project window, I can make sure that I use the right robot, the right reference frame, and the right tool. I can also adjust the value of the approach and retract movement before and after the cutting path. I will set those to 400 for the moment. Those movements here are now 4 times longer than they were. That will help us avoid any collisions with the part. If I needed, I could use that section of the window to adjust the orientation of the tool along the path. Now I can click Update and Simulate to see the early result. That seems very nice. Let's use the slider to see every portion of the path, especially the corners, just to make sure the transition is smooth. Okay, I think I'm quite lucky this time. I don't really need to adjust the orientation of the tool, but like I just said, this portion of the robot machining project is used to modify that orientation. We will talk about that in our next video. It will present a 3-axis machining of a simple mold, again using our Mastercam plugin. You can also use the Program Events button here to activate or deactivate IOs such as the rotation of your spindle. Okay, last thing to do is to generate the actual robot code. Make sure to use the right post-processor for your robot. Here, I have a Fennec. So, once that's correct, I can right-click on the car hood program and click Generate Robot Program. That window appears and the complete robot program is generated for the FANUC controller. You can see here all the points to reach and all the movements to do. Okay guys, that's pretty much everything for today's video. I really hope you enjoyed it. If you did, please subscribe to our channel. I will be posting a bunch of tutorials video on RoboDK and its features. If you want us to cover any other topics, let us know in the comment section below. And if you have any technical question about RoboDK, please visit our forum where our community will be more than happy to help you with your project. That being said, have a good day, guys.